those cooler conditions into next week, but for now we've got more of that heat. I'll explain everything coming up.
Right now on News Channel 6 at 5, a day of remembrance. How our community is honoring those lives lost on 9/11.
The city of Aiken says the bridge on Fairfield Street is worth saving. So why is it taking them so long to rebuild it? We've got the latest on the project.
And the Aiken County Board of Education calling a special meeting this afternoon. They're going to talk about back to school. We have live coverage as News Channel 6 at 5 starts now.
Live from Television Park, this is WGBF News Channel 6 at 5.
Good evening, everyone. Thanks so much for joining us. I'm Jenny Montgomery.
I'm Brad Means. Coverage you can count on begins with paying tribute to those killed September 11th. Fort Gordon honored them today in a ceremony. News Channel 6's Chloe Salsameda has the story.
The memory of September 11th touches Americans nationwide, especially firefighters. The firefighters here at Fort Gordon are unique. They also serve in the military. They say what happened 19 years ago lives with them every day and inspired them to serve their country.
At Fort Gordon, service members and troops gathered to hold a moment of silence to honor those killed on September 11th. Flags lowered to half staff and cannons fired at the exact times of the attack. Firefighters say the impact is still very strong today.
The amount of loss was just with the firefighters, I think that hit home to a lot of firefighters. Some of them knew that, you know, what they're getting into, that they weren't going to go home that evening.
The firefighters say it's important to continue holding ceremonies like the one today to remind younger generations of the sacrifices made on September 11th. At Fort Gordon, Chloe Salsameda, WJBF, News Channel 6.
Well, we do have some more storms coming into the area. It does look like they're kind of collected most into the Aiken County area and then the rest of the north of the CSRA. We do have some out in Columbia right now. I want to zoom in mostly on this system right here as it crosses over I-20. We do have a couple pockets of isolated storms surrounding it, but it's really this one that's going to be the main concern. While we aren't seeing any lightning strikes with it right now, it's been on and off throughout the entirety of its lifespan. And it's likely to continue on making its way, not really into our area, but the rest of the north of the CSRA, including those lakes region. Taking a look in Columbia, actually, we can see some of that cumulonimbus cloud, which is bringing another storm most likely to our area. However, it doesn't look like it's likely to really come into Augusta, mostly just stay up in the north of the CSRA. Temperatures right now at around 83, that dew point's still fairly high. It's going to be muggy and gross like that pretty much the rest of the weekend, so it's not going to be anything like Labor Day weekend. Hopefully we'll end up seeing an end to it, but it doesn't look like it's going to be coming. I'll have that full forecast for you coming up. Back to you, Jenny.
Ryan Gold, nice to have you with us in the studio today. The Aiken County School Board is holding a special meeting tonight to discuss back-to-school options. News Channel 6's Kim Vickers is live now in Aiken with more. Kim?
Thanks, Jenny. The school board is meeting in about half an hour for what they are calling a back-to-school discussion with Superintendent King Lawrence. They're expected to discuss and possibly vote on whether or not to send elementary school hybrid students back to school 5 days a week at 100% capacity. If approved, kids will start full-time on September 21st. This comes the day after Governor Henry McMaster urged educators to send students back to school 5 days a week. We'll have more on Aiken County School Board's decision tonight on WJBF at 11. Live in Aiken, I'm Kim Vickers, WJBF News Channel 6.
Kim, thanks. Looking ahead to tomorrow when people...
Now, your most accurate forecast with WJBF Live Viper 6.
A very different weekend this weekend expected than what we saw in the past. It's going to be a little bit warmer, and it's going to be a lot cloudier with a few more showers and storms to take warning for. We're also going to be seeing that humidity actually stick around and be trapped in the area. That and the tropics being active, we'll end up seeing a pretty big doozy of a system coming in through. Right now in Columbia, we're seeing a lot more of those storms continuing on here. A nice big cumulonimbus cloud that's actually heading into the CSRA now, much more to the north around where the lakes are going to be, and it's going to kind of dip into Aiken County as well on its pathway here. We are going to be seeing, at least for now, temperatures are going to be kind of ranging from those mid-80s to those lower 80s, at least for now, as we continue to dive on down into what we're going to be seeing for tonight's lows, which are expected to be in those mid-70s. We are going to have to worry a bit about the dew point, too, because it is going to continue to feel muggy and very humid over the next few days. Right now, we're going to be seeing a lot more of those showers coming straight off the coast. Bermuda high bringing a lot more of that moisture directly up and around, and it being trapped by what we've got here is that cold front that's going to become a stationary front for over the weekend, which is going to help keep in a lot more of that warmth and keep in a lot more of that moisture. So we'll see a lot more clouds than we were seeing over the last weekend. We've got a lot going on in the tropics here, two tropical storms that aren't really going to be doing much, at least for now. We've got two disturbances, one that's already in the ocean, one coming right off of the coast in Africa. This one's going to most likely become a tropical depression any day now. I would expect it to happen over the weekend. And we have another system right now in the Caribbean that does look like it's going to make its way into the coast there too. It might end up losing its energy before it can become a depression. We're going to keep our eyes on that. Speaking of keep our eyes on it, taking a look at what we've got going on for these two tropical storms that are going to end up becoming hurricanes, but luckily still over the ocean, we could end up seeing a little bit more of those clouds and rain come off it, though, just in the form of stretched out energy. Back in the CSRA, we've got a couple isolated storms and showers, at least to contend with for tomorrow afternoon. It does look like we'll end up seeing a break as we head into the evening, a little bit more of the opening in the sky there, a fewer showers, but then they're going to pick right back on up as we head into the overnight hours, and especially those late evenings. Could be seeing a couple more pop-up isolated showers. Not really expecting any storms with them, though. Low temperatures across the board for tonight into tomorrow morning are likely to remain fairly warm, well above average, the average being around 68 and 67. Those high temperatures, they're also going to be pretty warm, too. Taking a look at the 10-day forecast, we are going to end up seeing a lot more of that heat continuing in, cool down expected, especially as we head into the middle of the week, and then some more showers expected, but not so much for the rest of the week. Back to you, Jenny.
Ryan, thank you. With everyone working and learning from home, keeping track of things can be a little tricky. Here's how a smart speaker can help you and your family stay on top of things. Rich DeMura reports.
With everyone